A new installation in Kings County, Nova Scotia will pay tribute to 19th century inventor Dr. Abraham Gessner. Now, Gessner was the inventor of kerosene. He's known on this side of the bay for being the first provincial geologist. He also founded Canada's first natural history museum, which later became the New Brunswick Museum. Gessner grew up in Kentville, Nova Scotia. A national memorial was built there in the late 60s to honor him. But a philanthropist has hired Canadian sculptor Ruth Abernathy to create a new expanded installation, and she's on the phone. Good morning.
Good morning.
How did you come to be involved in this project?
Well, it's a story with a number of twists and turns, but indeed, I met Dr. Alan Eaves, who grew up in Nova Scotia, also attended Acadia and Dalhousie, and I met him at a job interview in Toronto, not my job, but we, in the first two sentences, made introductions, swapped business cards, and he said, you know, I have projects I want to do. They're rooted in Nova Scotia. They began with the railway, and from that first conversation, the list included the presentation of Abraham Gessner, because Alan really had come across the site and just felt that this was a story that deserved a larger narrative and a much greater awareness.
And did you know anything about Dr. Abraham Gessner before you started?
I did not. He has been a fascinating exploration. Curiously enough, in my time in the Valley just a week ago, it was astonishing to everyone involved how few people had ever even heard of him.
Well, what is on the site now?
Grown up near the site.
Well, sure. Actually, and I grew up, you know, down the road from Kentville, and I can't say that I knew very much about, if anything, about Dr. Abraham Gessner. So what is on the site right now?
Well, not a whole lot. This is the home that was owned by Gessner's by the Gessner family. They came as planters to work the diked land after the expulsion of the Acadians, of course. So Gessner is born in Cornwallis 1797. He's a very early fellow. And the site is near the Heritage Home, and it's essentially like a school lot. There's a place to pull off the road. There are two quite handsome Parks Canada plaques that tell the facts of his life. But the real story is much, much more interesting. And certainly, the more you look at the work that he did and the experiments he undertook, more is needed.
Hmm. What struck you most about his life, something that you're particularly interested in sharing?
I think in reading about him, it would be a mistake to present this life as skimming from one success to the other. He is early enough in the world of science. He's before Charles Darwin. You know, he's a working adult when John A. Macdonald is born. He's born in the year of the French Revolution. So he's just early in our history. So you really have to focus to understand the context of the people on the street at the time. You know, Nova Scotia was just a little colony, a British colony, with very rigid assumptions about who had social status and how things were. You know, it would have been religiously based in terms of its laws and perceptions. And here's this guy talking about what's under the ground. He wanted to talk about things like, you know, fossils and prehistory. You know, there was a mutual friend who, and some of Gessner's work and discovery documenting the Joggins site was very influential and fundamental to essentially verifying Darwin's origin of species. I mean, evolution was a concept that many people dismissed.
And was he outspoken on social issues as well?
He was ahead of his time that way. It was an amazingly broad spectrum. There was a point, because he was the geologist who undertook surveys of all Atlantic provinces, he did work with the Aboriginals and First Nations. And he was very concerned for their welfare, and they were in dire circumstances at that point. At one stage, he worked with representing a group of 10 chiefs. They went to Halifax to protest, to make their case, to request attention to their circumstance, and on the steps of the legislature. You know, they posed their case, they made a public appeal. Well, it did not go well. This is 100 years before Gandhi, and these were not decisions that were welcomed and embraced. It was not how things are done. And I felt that in his life, he did not thumb his nose at power, but I think he saw things in a way that others simply didn't. And that therein lies the rub, you know, where he faced a lot of pushback. He did not get the support that to him seemed so logical. You know, if this, then this, and here's a direction forward. And that kind of support was just not available to him. And it is astonishing in reading about him what he was up against, what he was able to accomplish within the constraints of time, money, and, my gosh, available energy. He's a hugely accomplished individual. But it was a very hard slog for many decades. It's almost heartbreaking, you know, but for his own personal energy. You know, he just figured that he was compelled to follow his interests.
We only have about 2 minutes left, Ruth, before national news takes over. But I'm wondering, how do you interpret all of that, and how do you represent all of that in your installation?
Well, sadly, I will just be making I'm making gestures. I have a design that essentially, for the contemporary mind, links a whale tail and an interpretive panels surrounding a courtyard, and links Gessner's interruption. He's a disruptor of the highest order. With the invention of kerosene, launching this industry that changes the world, not always for the better, which needs our discussion. But we are linking the whaling industry and technology through Gessner's invention to the petroleum industry, and hopefully launching all kinds of interesting questions and discussion.
And how soon can people see it?
Well, we are slated to dedicate the piece on Thanksgiving weekend. It's October 6th and 7th. Stay tuned. You know, this, of course, is underway. My work is underway. I mean, we could push the date out if we hit a snag, but at this point we haven't, and there's a great deal of interest. Plus, it aligns beautifully with Gessner's return to Nova Scotia, to the home farm that he and his father bought and sold between them several times, plus the Dalhousie 200th anniversary. It's a perfect alignment with that, because Gessner is one of the Dal 200 that are being celebrated throughout this year of anniversary celebrations for alumni and accomplishments. So it seems to be coming together beautifully, and it's a fascinating story.
Oh, I'm so glad that we could talk a little bit about it. And if there is a little bit of a delay, Ruth, that's okay if you get to spend a little bit more time in the Annapolis Valley.
Well, I'll be down. I have family there in New Brunswick and in the Valley, so that's always a pleasure. Yes, not the Briar Patch, Bear Rabbit. Yes, thank you so much for following up. It's a big pleasure, and I look forward to it.
Lovely to talk to you. Bye-bye now.
My pleasure. Bye-bye.
Ruth Abernethy is an award-winning Canadian sculptor. We reached her in Ontario this morning.